KMES English Medium Junior College welcome its 12th students for the lecture of philosophy. For the chapter 1, there is something, but what it is. For the topic, ultimate reality, number and nature, metaphysics in Indian philosophy. Students, in today's lecture, for chapter 1, there is something, but what it is. We are going to study about the following topics. Ultimate reality, number and nature, metaphysics in Indian philosophy, different darshana, namely Charvaka darshana, Jaina darshana, Vaisheshika darshana, Buddha darshana, Sankhya darshana, and Advaita Vedanta darshana. Students, coming to the topic of today, ultimate reality, number and nature. Before coming to the number and nature, let's understand what is ultimate reality. According to philosophers, though experience changes from person to person, the object of experience does not change. Its existence, structure, qualities are not dependent on experience. They are not affected by nature and how they are experienced. So, the object is existence and nature. Of an object is objective, even though its experience is subjective. That alone is real, the ultimate reality. This concept that remains same, the nature that remains same, is called ultimate reality. Let's understand this more by an example. Water is made of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen, named as H2O. The state of water can be solid, liquid, or gaseous. The state of water is determined by the temperature, which is conditional. But the nature of the water, that is H2O, is permanent. That is called the ultimate reality. Metaphysics in Indian philosophy. Traditionally, philosophy has been divided into different branches. Each branch deals with certain specific questions. Metaphysics is that branch of philosophy which deals with being or reality. In Indian tradition, both whether we talk about the orthodox tradition or heterodox schools of philosophy, they reflect upon number and nature of ultimate reality. It means both the school of Indian tradition, orthodox and heterodox, talk about the number and nature of ultimate reality. There are certain major tariff that is being put by this darshana. While taking the review of these tariffs in historical or chronological order, we come to know that majority of the Indian darshana believe in pluralism. The school or the darshana that believe in pluralism are Charvaka, Jaina, Mimamsa, Nyaya, and Vaisheshika. However, there is certain difference about their view regarding the nature of ultimate reality. But all of them believe in plurality. Charvaka is one of the Indian darshana which does not believe in pluralism. They accept materialism. According to them, materialism states that the fundamental nature of the universe is material. That means it is non-conscious and physical. It does not state that the consciousness is by product of matter. In the history of philosophy, it is observed that the materialistic are often pluralistic. It implies that the number of ultimate reality is more than two. Therefore, the theory believes that the fundamental principle of material, no matter what they are in number. Charvaka darshana. According to Charvaka, the universe is created out of four material elements. These four material elements are earth, water, fire, and air. There is no one creator of this universe. This universe is created by the interaction that goes between these four basic elements, and their compound produce everything in this universe. It does not require any creator. Existence of an independent substance or soul is generally accepted by many darshana on the basis of consciousness. Charvaka do accept consciousness. They rejected the notion of independent existing soul. They believe that the particular combination, a particular type of combination of these four basic elements produce the living or the unconscious body. The answer to how this non-living element produce a living thing, can produce a particular type of combination of these elements. This we will discuss later. Charvaka view are similar to the view of modern science. Just like science, Charvaka too believes in materialism and pluralism. So, the Indian thinkers, that is the Charvaka darshana, believe in four basic elements, that is earth, water, fire, air, and air. They rejected the element of ether. According to them, every worldly object is composed of four elements. The fusion or the combination of these four elements lead to creation of things. And separation of these elements lead to destruction. Although they believe their in soul, but as Chanaka educates materialism, they accept the gross matter as the only reality. The Chanaka accepts the visible empirical world as the only existing world. Since soul cannot be experienced, hence its existence is denied by Charvaka. Consciousness, that is soul, is nothing but a byproduct of the physical process. The soul in the living body is with the quality of consciousness, is the quality of consciousness. Let us know some more things about Charvaka. Charvaka accepts only four basic elements. So, looking at the characteristics of Charvaka philosophy, the Charvaka thought is characterized by an insistence on joy, full living, that is materialism, and hedonism, eat, drink, and be merry. Charvaka believed that the material universe did exist. The matter consists of five elements: earth, water, energy, air, and ether. Charvaka accepted the first four but rejected ether because its essence cannot be perceived. According to Charvaka, the visible empirical world is only existing world. Since soul or God cannot be experienced, hence their existence is denied by Charvaka. That Charvaka believes in there is no God. The supposition of God as a creator is unnecessary. The world comes into existence by spontaneous combination of material elements. Therefore, Charvaka denies moral and spiritual value and recognizes only material value. So, what is materialism according to Charvaka? Those who support materialism do not accept that there is a separate part of human body called as soul. An individual is a living physical body and nothing more. After death, the body dies and therefore the whole person ceases to exist. So this is the Charvaka view about the world. Students, in today's lecture, we are studied about the metaphysics, number and nature, and about one of the darshana, that is Charvaka darshana. The remaining darshana, that is Jnana, Vaisheshika, Buddha, Sankhya darshana, and Advaita Vedanta darshana, will be discussed in the next lecture.